The Albanese government's actually in big trouble on another front and has come out with a trick to bail it out. Now, the government desperately needs tomorrow's budget to save it because it's falling in the polls because of the cost of living crisis predominantly and the, I guess, the sense of drift. And elections are due early next year, so this is this big chance, but it's trapped. The government wants to give handouts because of the cost of living thing, but if it spends too much, that'll help boost, keep inflation too high. As the Prime Minister actually conceded today to Labor MPs.
Importantly, cost of living relief that doesn't add to inflation, indeed, that reduces inflation. And a tax cut for every single taxpayer, not just some.
Yeah. But good news for the government. The government's budget tomorrow is actually going to say inflation this financial year will actually be much lower than the Reserve Bank predicted. In fact, predicted just 6 days ago. Indeed, the government says inflation by December is going to be just 2.75%. And that's more than 1% lower than the Reserve Bank reckoned just a week ago. I'm assuming that that may be because of something like rebates on power bills coming up in this budget to bring down inflation. But I also assume that the government could then treat this as an excuse to again spend more than it should, which is wonderful for the government. Joining me is the Monday political panel, Michael Kroger, former Victorian Liberal president, and Steve Conroy, former Labor senator and cabinet minister. Michael Kroger, that's a huge difference, really, in the scheme of things between the government and the Reserve Bank. Inflation by December, the government says 2.75, the Reserve Bank says no, 3.8. How do you explain that?
Well, Andrew, this is absolutely fascinating, and I'll explain it this way. At her press conference last week, the governor of the Reserve Bank was asked by an enterprising journalist, did you discuss at the meeting the day before raising rates? And she said, we discussed raising rates and keeping them the same. What's missing from that answer? And so one economist last week said rates might be raised three times. That won't happen. There's never any chance of that happening. If there were two rate rises of, say, 0.25, 0.25, the government probably won't be re-elected. One rate rise, they could probably get away with. But the government is absolutely desperate to make sure there are no increases in interest rates, which is why you come back to the inflation number. I think what the government are trying to do here is intimidate the Reserve Bank. That's the only thing I can say. The difference between the two estimates is so massive. They're trying to intimidate the Reserve Bank into saying to them, we're moving into a low inflation environment. Don't you dare even think about raising rates. We're going to 2.75 at the end of the year. You're saying, you know, 3.8, 3.5 over the fiscal 25 year. Inflation's going down. We've got it under control. We're not spending too much. Don't you dare increase rates. And that's what they're doing to the Reserve Bank. They're trying to create a climate, Andrew, where there's no need to increase interest rates.
That said, Stephen Connor, of course, Treasury, say, you know, the government's budget papers are allegedly backed by Treasury, so I presume there's something behind it. Can you explain the difference between the government saying...
Yeah, really simply, Andrew. I can explain it really simply. The Reserve Bank are clowns.
Yeah.
OK? In the last 10 years, they have a target...
That's an easy
..between 2 and 3%. Do you know how many times... No, I'm going to actually be fact-based about why they're clowns. OK? Last 10 years, 2 to 3%. Do you know how many times they've achieved it? Four times. Four times. That's it. Just that. They have not got their forecasts right 80% of the time. 80% of the time, the Reserve Bank have got it wrong. And I was brutal on Philip Lowe, and I will be brutal
on
Michelle.
Just wrong. Can I ask you one thing about it? Yeah, they're wrong, you say, four times. Do they actually tend to be wrong by underestimating inflation?
Up, below or above? Both. That's the problem. Both.
Underestimating?
Okay? Wage forecasts for both, under and over. So, inflation, wrong for 10 years. Now let's talk about wage forecasts of those clowns at the Reserve Bank. Wrong. For 10 years straight. They didn't get close
again,
on
the
wage forecasts.
Forecasts
these,
are higher.
These people, no,
the wage
they've
forecasts
got them,
have
they've, forecasted them higher and they've been lower. No, they've estimated them higher. The actual real world for
Not
10
lately.
Years has been lower. Now, right. I said the 10 years. Okay,
well, let's
before
see
we
by
came
December. Okay.
And I remember
okay.
Phil Lowe.
You made your point.
Phil Lowe playing the good guy.
You made your point.
It's not that long
Stephen,
ago Phil Lowe
point.
Wanted to be the... No, I haven't finished.
Yeah. Treasury forecast.
Yeah, well, I think you have.
Stephen
They're clowns. Clowns. They're clowns.
They certainly
are
can't, they certainly can't forecast the price
by December,
of iron ore. No question.
The
they're all clowns.
Okay. Okay, they're all clowns. That's easy. Well, that was solved. Meanwhile,
easy.
Michael,
today,
no, they're just wrong. And they're factually, provably wrong.